Hi, welcome to part two of the six-part series looking at how to create a maze game using Pygame. In this part, we are going to develop a helper function to assist us with scaling images, iterate through a series of folders allowing us to import images into arrays, enhance the character class to allow it to accept that array of images, and update the display to show the images according to the timings within the game and also to the actions you take as the player. So the first thing we're going to do is on main.py, we are going to create this helper function. We're going to define the helper function and call it scaleImage, and it's going to take in as an input the image and how much you want to scale it by. This helper function returns the results of using pygame.transform.scale with the input of the image, and then it uses the scale to specify how much it needs to be scaled by taking the image's width and multiplying it by the scale, and then the image's height and multiplying it by the scale to say that we want this image to be this particular height and this particular width. So now we've got this scale image function, we are going to load in the player's animation images. So these are a series of animations that we are going to utilize to simulate animation. So we are going to create an array called animation types, and this is going to contain the two different types of animation that our character is going to have. It's going to have one animation for when it's idle and one animation for when it's running. Now when it's running, it's going to have four different directions that it can move in, so we are going to create an array called directions that contains the values up, down, left and right, and there will be animations associated with each direction. We're then going to have an array called movement Annie, which we're going to set as an empty array to begin with. We are then going to go through a for loop, which is going to iterate through the animation types array, and we're going to create a temporary array called animation. And if the type coming in is running, we're going to do something different than we would if it was idle. For each direction that the character is facing in the directions array, we're going to create a temp list array and then iterate through all of the files that are stored in a particular folder. Now there are four images for each direction, and we're going to create a variable called image, which is going to hold a Pygame image, and it's going to load from a folder called assets images character slash, and this is where we're getting into the realms of utilizing those variables that are passing through the loops. So it's going to take type and then direction and then the number in the range that we're looping through. So every time it goes round this loop, depending on what direction it is and where it is in the first for loop, it will look for a different file and load a different file. We're then going to dot convert alpha, the image that we've loaded, to make sure that it can be represented on screen. If you look at the folder that we're now showing you, you can see how in the up folder there are the four images. We're then going to scale that image by putting in img, which is the value we've stored that loaded file, and we're going to scale it by a scale that's going to be on our constants file called pscale. We're then going to append that item to our temporary list, and then we come out of this loop. outside the loop, we're going to take all these files and append them to the animation list we created. And that will later be appended to movement underscore Annie. We're then going to look at the idle animations. Now, there are only two idle animations in this situation for all of the images in the range. It currently says four. I will change it to two shortly. We're going to store the image as IMG, and we have updated the file reference to not include the direction variable because idle doesn't have a direction. So again, we're taking Pygame image load, then the file location, and then we convert alphaing it to make sure it's suitable for representing on the screen. We're then going to scale it by the same scale amount using our helper function, and then we're going to append to the animation array this image. We're then going to take what we've got stored in the animation array and store it in an array called movement underscore Annie. And that is a process for loading the images. Going to move on to look at our player where we created the character last part and adding into what we're passing into character that movement underscore Annie array. So we need to go to our character file and add into the initialization section this animation. So our self.animation is equal to the animation that we have passed in when we have initialized or created the character. And then we're going to make some new values for the player. We're going to have self.frameIndex, which we're setting to 0 to begin with. We're going to have self.action, which we're also setting to 0. Self.direction, which we are initializing at 3, and 0 in this situation is up, 1 is down, 2 is left, and 3 is right. And this corresponds to the locations that those directions were in that directions array we initialized earlier. We've then got self.update time, and this is going to be the time that we last updated the frame of the animation, and we're setting that to be pygame.time.getticks. And then we've got self.running, which is an indication of whether the character is idle or whether the character is running, and we're initializing that as false. Self.image, which is equal to the image that we are using at that point in time. So it's the self.animation and then the location within that animation array. So self.action is the first array element and self.framex index is the second one. We're then going to update self.rect and make it get the size of the character's rectangle from the image of the character. And that's all we are doing in the initializations part. Moving on to look at the animation. So this is within the move method. So if the character's DX or DY is not 0, that means they're moving, we're going to set self.running to be true. Otherwise, we're going to set self.running to be false. We're then going to look at what direction is our character facing. So if dy is less than 0, the character is moving up the screen, and therefore we're setting self.direction to be equal to 0 to indicate the character is moving up. If dy is greater than 0, then they are moving down the screen. So we're setting self.direction to equal to 1. If dx is less than 0, we are setting self.direction equal to 2. else we're going to set our direction to be 3. And we're doing elifs here. So these directions will have priorities. So if you are first, it will check up and down first, and then it will check left before it checks right. We're now going to create a new method called update, and this is what we're going to use to update that image that we are showing that will simulate the animation. We're going to look to see if we are running, and if we are, it's going to run a helper function called updateAction, and it's going to pass the value 1 in. Otherwise, it's going to run that updateAction helper method, and it's going to pass the value 0 in. And the helper method, updateAction, takes in the instance of the character as well as the new action for it. So if the new action is not the same as the action that the character is currently doing, it's going to change instance's action to be the new action. It's going to set the frame index back to 0, so it starts the movement animations from the beginning, and it is going to update the last time that the file was updated. And moving back to the update method, we're going to set the animation cooldown to be twice the frames per second. So let's look at updating the image. If the character is moving, so self.running is true, we're going to set a variable called AniList or animation list to equal the self.animation referenced by the self.action and then the self.direction. So this will load into that array the files for that particular direction. If it's not running, it's just going to load in the idle images. So once we've done this else, we're going to set the image of the instance to equal the value that's the frame index within the AniList array. And if the current time on the system minus the last time we updated is greater than the cooldown time, we're going to increase the frame index by 1. And then we're going to check to see if the value is still within the bounds of the array. So we're going to take the value that we've just increased and take the modulus of it by the length of the number of AniList array. And we're then going to set our update time to be equal to the current time of the game, and therefore reset how long it will be till the image changes again. We're now going to go to our draw method. And we're now going to make sure that that image is shown on the screen, and we're going to use something called blit. So we're going to blit onto the surface that was passed into the draw the image in the location of the rectangle that the image is contained within. And I'm going to change that rectangle that we drew previously to just be an outline, just so I know where the collide points are of that rectangle. Moving back across to constants, we need to add in some new constants. So the first one we're adding in is P scale. So this is the amount we're scaling the player's image. And we're going to set that to 1.5. Just test this out. So if you look, the character now has an image, but when we move around, it's not updating. And that is because on the main page, we haven't used this update method. We haven't called that update method from the main file. So moving over to the main file and going into the loop, the game loop, underneath where we moved the character, we're going to add in that we want to update the character as well. So now when we run it, you can see that the character is idle and bouncing up and down, waiting for you to do something. And when we move, he runs down, runs up, runs to the left, and runs to the right. Join us in the next part to improve the UI and start to implement the level tiles and mazes.